Joe Dredge.
The show goes on! Yeah!
Mornings on WROK. Over 95 years in the books and still on top. This is Rockford's News Talk 1440 WROK.
7 minutes after 8 at News Talk 1440 WROK. It's a Monday morning with Riley and Joe, Wild Rose Casino and Resort, Clinton, Iowa, show sponsor that we're grateful for. Mm-hmm. Cloudy and 33. It feels like it's 24. We're going to hit right around the 48 mark today with an equal opportunity to draw some rain. 48-48.
All right.
Tonight we drop to 37. Tomorrow we top out at 40 with an 80% chance of a wintry mix. Tuesday night's cold at 13. Wednesday's 24 down to 17. Thursday's 27 down to 14. Friday's 26. We go down to 10. So that's what you can look forward to.
Little bit of snow still outside.
Yeah.
Little bit.
A little tiny bit. Enough for you to accidentally slip and fall on.
Yes, we can get rid of that today.
Yep. It'll just be that it's one fun. Patch. You're looking, there's 4 acres of nothing. You slip on that one patch.
Yeah.
This is unusual. Doghouses generally don't go for a whole lot of money when someone decides to sell one.
No.
The one I'm looking at here, they're expected to draw, $200,000 to $300,000 for it.
It's too much for a doghouse.
Have a look. See it?
For that one?
That one.
That better be a famous dog's doghouse.
Well, it is fairly famous.
Is that, what was the, who was the dog on Bozo the Clown?
Well, I don't know.
Yeah, there's a dog and he had a doghouse.
I'm unfamiliar. I used to watch the regular show, not the cartoon. So the regular one? Well, I guess when I was a kid, it was pre-dog for Bozo at that time.
What is it? Stuffy or Cuddly Dudley?
Cuddly Dudley. Oh, I remember the cartoon. Yeah. Oh, I'm sure. I remember that.
Yeah. Cuddly.
Oh gosh, with Ray Rayner. God, that's way back. That's when I was a little kid.
First, your Cuddly Dudley showed up on Bozo. Maybe that was a late edition.
Must have been.
Okay.
Must have been. Yeah. This one, no Cuddly Dudley involved in it. It's a doghouse. It looks to be a simple one. It's got an R printed on the front of it. They're expecting it to go for $200,000 to $300,000 for a reason.
The very first rover?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
It's a doghouse from Costa Rica that was struck by a meteorite on April 23rd, 2019. The occupant of the doghouse, a German shepherd named Roki, was not injured during the incident, although the dog was understandably freaked out by it.
A meteor hit the doghouse?
Meteorite blew right through the roof. You can't see it from the angle here. There's another photo. I don't know if you can see right there.
Okay.
There's a hole in the roof.
Sure.
Yeah, that's from a meteorite blasting through it while Roki, the German shepherd, was inside. Uninjured.
Usually doesn't work out well for the inhabitants.
Nope. Auction is part of an online-only series called Deep Impact, Martian, Lunar, and Other Rare Meteorites, which is running until Wednesday. James Hyslop, head of Science and Natural History for Christie, said this is a really exciting auction, an opportunity for collectors. Meteorites are incredibly rare. The combined weight of all the known meteorites that we have is less than the annual output of gold.
Oh, okay.
Ever since an exhibition in Paris featured a car famously struck by a meteorite, I've wanted to bring an object hit by an extraterrestrial object to auction.
Okay.
There are not many, and I'm thrilled now to be able to offer Roki's celebrated meteorite-impacted doghouse and its accompanying impactor. The meteorite that struck the house will also go up for auction. They figure that'll go for $60,000.
Wait, so you do get the meteorite involved in this?
Yeah, the impactor.
The impactor. Okay.
Yep. No, that's separate.
Oh, that is separate.
That's separate. You buy the doghouse for the $200,000 to $300,000. You want the meteorite to put the hole in the roof. That'll run you another $60,000, they hope.
What? How is the meteorite cheaper than the house?
That's a great question. I don't know.
I kind of understand the significance of the house, but if it was a package deal, but the meteorite sounds to be much more valuable than the doghouse.
I would think so, too.
I don't understand this.
Quote, awe and wonder seem to be in short supply these days, but not when you have in your hand an object from outer space that's older than the planet Earth, an object that delivered the precursors of life to our planet billions of years ago, and then billions of years later ended the reign of the dinosaurs and the opening for humankind, according to the director of the auction. a man given to some hyperbole.
Yes.
So, yeah, German Shepherd named Roki, not injured in the incident April 23rd, 2019, but that meteorite did blow right through the roof of his doghouse.
All right.
And now they have it sitting on a thing of AstroTurf in a square with a bowl out in front of it as far as the auction goes. Yeah.
The bowl is great.
Yeah, the orange bowl sitting just outside the dog's house is a nice touch.
I think that was original? With that house?
I'm thinking they probably threw it in.
All right.
I would be interested to know what happened. People show up at the house. Hey, listen, I buy that from you?
Uh-huh.
What? The doghouse. Well, it's got a hole in it.
I mean,
a meteorite blew. Yeah. Really? Yeah, I'll give you $500 for it. Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Yeah, that piece of crap? Sure.
Yeah, then later on you find out they sold it for $300,000 at an auction.
Wow. I had no idea there was such the market for meteorite damaged property.
Or meteorites or just the market for meteorites.
Well, I kind of understood that. I mean, yeah, meteorites are cool. I mean, that is something from space. It's neat. I don't know why the doghouse is going for four times as much.
That's it. How much do meteorites sell for? Cost depends on the kind of meteorite. There are three basic types: stones, irons, and stony irons. Which, by the way, great backup infielder for the Cubs in the 60s.
Stony Irons,
yeah. Guy, switch hitter.
He can hit.
Stones consist of ordinary chondrites, which sell for between $3 and $10 per gram. So, yeah, can they be sold? Obviously, they can be sold. Some are sold as complete stones, as slices, end cuts, broken fragments. Sometimes the buyer may have a choice about the type of specimen for the particular meteorite they want.
Okay.
Are they a good investment? A guy named Rob, a British guy, says, it's treated us well financially. They apparently sold a meteorite at an auction. There's no set price for meteorites. They are a finite resource and most of them increase in value.
Okay. You think they decrease in value because ostensibly as we continue our march through time, we'll just collect more and more meteorites.
Right.
They're becoming less scarce as the day goes by.
1 pound meteorite could get you as much as $1 million. Meteorites are rarer than gold, rarer than platinum, rarer than diamonds, rarer than emeralds.
Okay. Really?
Top meteorite hunting place? It's a long way from here. Antarctica.
Oh, yeah. Probably just untouched.
Yep. Also, the desert in the northwest region of the African continent and the American Southwest. Antarctica is particularly cool because it's a desert of snow and ice and dark, weird-looking rock from space is fairly easy to spot.
Yeah, but you got to be traipsing around Antarctica for it.
You have to traipse around Antarctica for it.
Okay.
So there's going to be a considerable investment on the front end to getting this rolling.
Easier to get to Arizona.
One would think. I think it'd be easier to get to an African desert, too, than it would be to get down to Antarctica.
Uh-huh.
But, yeah, some of their prices are absolutely astronomical. The Rob Report, which is like a rich guy catalog.
Oh, really? The Rob Report?
Yep. Among the sales standout lots, sculpted 70-pound Canyon Diablo iron meteorite from the famous Arizona Meteor Crater achieved an online record of $237,500.
Oh, boy, this Rob Report. You can just tell it's a rich place from the...
Oh, I love... My dentist has the Rob Report sitting in the... Well, I used to before they threw it out because, you know, you'll get COVID from reading.
Uh-huh.
But I used to always hunt through the magazines that were sitting there because he'd get the Rob Report and I would just go through it. And it's all sorts of things that you'll never be able to afford and that look really fun.
Nine exciting yachts debuting at the Miami International Boat Show. Do you know there was nine new yachts debuting this year?
You know, I did not. I thought there were eight. Yeah, I thought there were eight.
Boat of the week, forget yachts. This mini sub can be towed behind your truck like a jet ski. Some great stories that really I can relate to here.
By the way, Indian billionaire Naveen Jain, a space entrepreneur, once ranked number 121 on the Forbes 400 list of the richest people in the world, has a meteorite collection worth $5 million. Steven Spielberg, Elon Musk, Nicolas Cage, illusionist Uri Geller, and cellist Yo-Yo Ma are also meteorite collectors.
What a collection of folk there.
They're also meteorite collectors.
Collectors?
Collectors.
Meaning
they're,
more
they
more
find
than
out
one?
What, yeah, yeah. This guy, one guy's got a collection of them, several, $5 million worth.
Just on display?
I don't know what you do with it.
You making jewelry out of this?
I have no idea what you do with it once you get it. It's like, you know, I just bought this Van Gogh thing for $110 million. What are you going to do with it? I don't know. You think, I can't hang it up.
You think jewelry would be the number one thing?
Yeah, I think. I don't know, you're doing it for the investment, just let her sit right there and appreciate in value.
Do you have any pictures of them?
I have pictures of meteorites, but not of anybody's collection.
Okay. Are they pretty at all?
Some of them are pretty cool looking, yeah. The ones that have a lot of metal to them have a really neat look. They look like a chunk of melted metal over rock.
Okay. Well, there are some nice ones.
Pretty cool. But if you ever happen to find one, yeah, you're going to be in for some dough.
Buy one on eBay for 10 grand.
Okay, there you go. See, there had to be people who have them up for sale at some place that you could just jump aboard and go, oh, you know what? I don't know much about. I'll learn now.
I'm sorry, $10,090.
Okay.
Yeah, I get shipping.
Right.
They don't throw that in.
Does it surprise you one iota that Elon Musk collects them?
Not at all.
Not.
And I want to know what he's doing with it.
Yeah,
he's doing
too.
Something weird.
Oh, yeah. He's probably, you know, they're building a snowman in the backyard. He's using that for the buttons.
He's got dividing rods, figuring out how to activate them. He's literally, who's Snap guy?
What's his name? From the
Thanos.
Marvel movie.
He's really Thanos.
Yeah.
Collecting, you know, the 6 special meteorites that will.
I figure when the truck finally comes out, they'll have one that like hangs from the rearview mirror. Little meteorite is a little add-on bonus there for you.
Two of them. Like dice.
Yeah, in case you need to break a window if your car goes in water.
You're fine.
818, here's Hannity.
Over 95 years in the books and still on top. This is Rockford's News Talk 1440 WROK.
824 News Talk 1440 WROK. Cloudy and 33, feeling like 24. News in 6 minutes.
A couple things. One caller called in and we're talking about meteorite memorabilia.
Yeah.
He pointed to the Cabot. Is it Cabot guns?
Oh, yeah.
Cabot Guns.
Yeah, I remember looking those up about a year or so back.
Cabot Guns makes a couple of very, very pretty handguns with meteorite in the grip there.
Yep, meteorite, genuine meteorite grip, .45 caliber, absolutely beautiful, handcrafted weapons.
That pair will run you, according to the Ra report, which I just found out about today, it's a great place, $4.5 million for that.
So. For the pair or one?
For the pair.
For the pair. You get two of them.
Get two of them. Yeah, one for the right, one for the left.
$2.25 million. Not bad now.
I mean, now we're talking obtainable.
Yeah. As I said to you off the air, I've got Jeff Bezos money. I'm still not buying that.
I don't need that gun. That's
I don't need that. I'd just be afraid. And, I dropped it. Oh, no.
Well, it's a meteorite.
Is the grip chipped? Yeah, I think it cracked.
Well, the meteorite, it came from space. I think it can handle you dropping it on porcelain.
I don't know.
Maybe I.
Because they have trimmed it since then.
That's right. It's not not original quality.
Yeah. No thanks.
But then another note, a sports note that's kind of dropped this morning. Somebody said this is how you know the MLB lockout's gone too long, because Bruce Levine, a Chicago reporter, has some interesting Blackhawk updates. Now Blackhawks in. Image shift mode right now, fair to say.
Image hell right now. So, yeah, they better get it shifted.
Step one, Jay Zawoski saying this, Bruce Levine reports that the Blackhawks and Bobby Hull have parted ways in an amicable separation. The team says they are reevaluating their ambassador roles, and Hull is no longer one of them. So Bobby Hull is persona non grata around the United Center now.
There's some background on that, is there not?
I don't know if there's recent background, but if you do just a cursory Google search on some of the troubles that Bobby Hull had in the past, especially with some spousal abuse, it's not good. It's very, very ugly. Miss Hull often showing up to Blackhawks games when the scarf and sunglasses look to hide things. It's been I don't even know if it's been.
For those who don't understand that reference, old timey way of let's cover up black eyes and other signs of domestic abuse.
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah. I don't even know if open secret's the right word to use about this. Everyone's known about Bobby Hull's kind of ugly past for a long time. And the Blackhawks have kind of just swept it under the rug, which I kind of understand. I mean, he's such the face of that era of your franchise, and beloved by fans in the time when,
until those fans become aware,
until they become aware, until you become aware, which I don't know if it's the Blackhawks' job to point that out, but
sportsmockery.com doesn't mind doing it.
No, no. There's been plenty of outlets that don't mind doing it.
Yeah, quoting this one, Joanne McKay, second wife of Bobby Hull, issued a graphic description of an incident that occurred while the two vacationed in Hawaii in 1966. Quote, I looked the worst after that Hawaii incident. I took a real beating there. Bobby just picked me up, threw me over his shoulder, threw me in the room, proceeded to knock the hell out of me, took my shoe with a steel heel, and proceeded to hit me in the head. I was covered with blood. I can remember him holding me over the balcony, and I thought, that's it. This is the end. I'm going.
Yeah. Yeah, imagine going to a nice Hawaiian vacation with your husband, yep, and then fearing for your life.
She filed for divorce after he threatened her life with a loaded shotgun.
Oh, I didn't know either of those stories, to be honest with you.
Yep, remarried, third wife, abuse didn't stop. 2 years in, arrested in a Willowbrook parking garage, charges of domestic assault and battery. When police arrived to apprehend him, they discovered him drunk, his wife severely beaten. Attempted to detain the belligerent Hull, the Hall of Fame forward physically lashed out at the arresting officers.
I think everybody knew about the drinking. Bobby's always had a reputation of that, but the... this isn't one or two times or even one or two women. This is three at least separate wives.
Yep.
All of them confirming some pretty ugly stories about Bobby Hull. And for my liking, he was ambassador for the Blackhawks far too long. I don't know if you have to kick him out of the building every time he shows up, but having his name actually tied to your organization as an official ambassador, that's...
See, here's the thing. I'm him, then I don't show up at your building.
Exactly.
I don't want any more of this.
Aren't you embarrassed a little bit?
You ought to be.
You really, really should be embarrassed.
You really, really ought to be.
Yeah.
Because the way you have done things is not the sort of example you would want someone else to follow.
I don't think he's even denied it. I don't think we're even anywhere close to a he said, she said situation. I think he's, I don't know if admitted it. But there's never been any pushback from Bobby Hull or his camp on any of these stories, which leads even more credence to it. So,
right.
Blackhawks.
Say that's it. Hey. He's done.
Step one, guys.
Well, yeah, I was going to say, if you're cleaning house of the bad things that have caused your organization significant pain and financial hemorrhage.
Decent place to start.
I would keep sweeping.
Oh, they're going to find a lot more.
I would keep sweeping some of these things away because, man, I just Google Bobby Hull as an a-hole just for the heck of it. I can't Endless. Read everything that I'm seeing here. It's
Over 95 years in the books and still on top. This is Rockford's News Talk 1440 WROK.
It's 8:35 at News Talk 1440 WROK. It's Riley and Joe. It's a Monday morning. It's cloudy. It's 33 with a wind. It feels like it's 24. Headed for about 48 with about a 48% chance of us drawing some sort of precipitation. Tomorrow's 40 with an 80% chance. Wednesday's 24. Thursday's 27. Friday's 26.
Okay.
That's where we sit.
That's good.
Put up a post last week here at 1440wrok.com, or better yet, grab the app to download and see what we have up there for you. How it might be a little more difficult to obtain an avocado.
Yeah.
And if you do, you're going to spend more for it. Well, the prohibition of the importation of Mexican avocados didn't last very long.
We're back?
Yeah. They started it on Super Bowl Sunday.
Okay.
Right after the Mexican avocado grower spent $7 million on a commercial.
Well, yeah, but they've already, you want to get your name out there for the commercial. That's fine. But I'm assuming Super Bowl Sunday has got to be a huge avocado day.
Oh, it is.
I mean, it's got to be one of our top.
One of the top ones of the year.
Of the year. So they've already sold all the avocados for the Super Bowl, ostensibly, right?
True. So they kicked out that $7 million, not counting production costs.
Right.
And right before the Super Bowl, the announcement was made that we're banning the importation because there's only one state in Mexico that has an agreement to ship their avocados here. we pulled the plug on it because one of the agriculture agents from America who's down there got death threats from one of the cartels.
Oh, that's right. Yep.
For him and his family. So instantly imports were frozen.
Right.
Blah, 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 blah. Lasted about 5 days. They put him back into the mix again.
I would say a lot of those people that saw the commercial probably won't buy another avocado for another year anyway.
Right. So there's that.
Now they know it's Mexican avocados they want.
But here's the thing about avocados. Apparently, all sorts of wondrous things come with having an avocado for you. You know, we do our, our coffee good, coffee bad segments. Here's our avocados good segment.
The I'm sure we're going to get to it, but like the fatty part of it is supposed to be outstanding for
There's
you.
There's lots of things about it, and I don't have them very often. Occasionally they'll come home, but you know, we don't have them very often. They're called a superfood for a good reason, according to studyfinds.org. Delicious dietary staple for millions of people, but they carry powerful health benefits. Good for your heart, helps lower your cholesterol, helps with weight loss, boosts your brain, all sorts of things. For example, an avocado a day keeps poor gut health away.
Really?
Scientists report, avocados have a positive effect on your gut health. Studies suggest that adding an avocado to just one meal per day can improve the diversity of microbes in your gut and the healthy substances they create. Study looked at 163 adults between 25 and 45 years of age who will fall into the category of overweight or obese. Each person had one meal a day replaced at either breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Part of the group had avocado with this test meal, while a control group had a similar meal, no avocado.
Gotcha.
Results revealed the avocados are rich in fat. Participants eating the fruit consume more calories. They also excreted more fat than the control group.
Let's go.
Greater fat excretion means the participants were absorbing less energy from the foods that they were eating. Study adds, avocados are high in dietary fiber and monounsaturated fat. Heart
That's the
healthy.
Good one.
Yep. Also discovering that eating the fruit daily creates a greater number of gut microbes that help break down the fiber to make it work even better.
Wow. So it helps itself.
Yes. It gives you the fiber, and then the microbes in it help break down the fiber so you get the maximum benefit.
It's like, hey, we're going to give you some fiber. Oh, looks like you're having trouble with that fiber. Why don't we help you out?
Why don't we help you out here? Because we're good guys.
Evolution's awesome sometimes.
It is. You got the bad cholesterol you're worried about. Incorporating an avocado into your daily diet helps in lowering bad cholesterol levels in your body, according to a study at Penn State. Bad cholesterol, LDL, narrows your arteries, restricts the flow of blood throughout the body. Study gathered 45 adult subjects, all of whom were either overweight or obese. Each adult followed an initial two-week run-in diet designed to follow a typical American diet. Mm-hmm. Assigned in three random separate diets within 5 weeks were a low-fat diet, a moderate-fat diet, and a moderate-fat diet that included one avocado per day.
Okay.
Researchers found people on the avocado diet had fewer oxidized LDL particles. They also had more lutein, L-U-T-E-I-N, which may be the bioactive that's protecting the LDL from being oxidized.
Sounds good.
Winner. Have them
one a day is a lot.
Having an avocado a day, that's a pretty good amount. I could get away with it, I think. But
you could. You do like them?
I do like. Oh, absolutely.
You just don't have them very often?
Yeah, we just don't grab them all that often. I found, after poking fun at the millennial habit of avocado toast.
Delicious.
Until I made my own one time at home after watching a YouTube video. Uh-huh. It was fantastic.
It's outstanding. Yeah.
But I slice them thin rather than mush them.
Oh, okay.
And then I like over the top of it, everything bagel seasoning.
That stuff makes a lot of things magical.
That, and if you throw some salsa or...
How about capers?
I would go with capers. I love capers.
Yes,
I like
good.
That salty.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Yep. But if you put some of that on, or what's the other? It's not salsa. It's chopped up tomatoes.
Pico de gallo?
Pico. Pico is killer on avocado toast.
Okay.
So I you know, my kids kind of poked some fun at, oh, okay, now it's cool because you're having it. I'm like, well, yeah.
Yeah, obviously.
It wasn't cool until I did. It is.
I really only consume it and only like it in guacamole form.
And I really like guacamole.
Yeah, I make it.
Depending on how it's made.
Yeah, I don't think I like avocados, but I like guacamole. Guacamole is so good, it overrides it. So I can actually eat guacamole. And it's, does that make any sense?
Not really, okay. No. Because it's avocado forward, regardless of how it's made.
Well, I do make it at about 50% avocados in the guacamole.
What's the rest?
salsa stuff, peppers, onions, lime juice.
All right.
Stuff. I'll bring you in. Next time I make it, I'll bring you
Please
in.
Please do. I'll have at it. I'd love to.
All right.
Daily consumption of an avocado strengthens your eyes and your brain. Study followed 40 healthy adults, 50 and over, who ate one fresh avocado per day for 6 months. Studies in the control group either ate a medium potato or a cup of chickpeas instead of the avocado. Provides the same calories. Control foods have little lutein or monounsaturated fats. Results found a 25% increase in lutein in the eyes of those who eat an avocado every day. Participants also showed better results on cognition tests, measuring memory, processing speed, and attention levels than those who were in the control group.
Hmm. It is one of those super, it's like in that, like that good tuna
right.
thing that makes, you know, the Japanese culture live till 95.
Exactly. Yeah. It's got all of that stuff in it. The seeds could contain a gold mine of compounds useful for treating a plethora of debilitating diseases. They enhance the effectiveness of cosmetics, perfumes, and other consumer goods. In a study, 300 dried avocado seed husks were ground into 21 ounces of powder. Further processing reduced about 3 teaspoons of seed husk oil, a little more than 1 ounce of seed husk wax. Researchers found 116 compounds in the oil and 16 of them in the wax, medicinal compounds that can be used to treat cancer, heart disease, and other conditions.
We're doing all this with the pits?
All of that with the husk from the pit.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
And
you guys just throw it away?
Yeah,
obviously.
Chuck it. Yeah. When Amy makes this the thing that's got avocado and it's a southwestern bean dip sort of thing, uh-huh. but it's got avocado in it. She'll throw the pits into it while it chills.
Oh,
and then when it's time for serving, they come out.
What does that do?
I don't know.
Okay,
I don't know, but I saw her deliberately do that and then warn ahead of time. Hey, when we're going to serve that, pluck those out.
Well, if you accidentally eat that, you're really not paying attention.
Not at all. You're really hammered at that point. So I don't know why she leaves the pit in. It doesn't have any negative effect. Southwest bean dip she makes is just unbelievable.
I thought she might like fill the cavities with something like cheese sauce. Okay.
Just leaves. There's usually a couple of them in there, depending on the amount of avocados that go in. Yeah, there's usually a couple of them that sit in there, and then when it's time for serving, they get plucked and trashed, and the stuff goes onto the table.
I've somehow slipped into avocado TikTok on the Clock app, and numerous people have shown me how incredibly easy it is to get your new avocado plant. Just from the pit there. You're like a little.
You just plant the pit?
Yeah, you put it in water for a day or two. Yeah, I think you might have to take that husk off. But you do that, and before you know it, you've got an avocado tree in your backyard. Maybe I'll grow that out back next this year.
Yeah, that's a problem, because California is, I think, the only other avocado-producing state, and they have their problems with it as well, even given nice California weather.
I grew a palm tree in that thing. I grew an avocado tree. That,
you know, that's true. By the way, the pit protects the guac simply because it shields a portion of the dip surface from exposure to air.
Okay.
Recommending someone leave pits in a bowl of guac to prevent browning is a bit like recommending people cover their heads tightly with their hands to prevent their hair from getting wet in a rainstorm.
Okay.
It would help, but not as much as an umbrella. Your best umbrella would be to put plastic wrap over the top of it to limit the oxygen.
Oh.
The pit isn't really necessary.
So this is like an old wives' tale type thing.
Yep.
That was probably just passed down to her from whoever she saw.
Yep.
You just put the pit in.
Throw the pit in the guac until you're ready to serve it. Get it out of there. It'll help keep it fresh and keep it from browning.
Might not. Well, whatever. Just keep doing it.
Oh, by the way, avocado, that name traced all the way back to the ancient Aztecs. The word means testicle.
It really does?
It does.
Oh.
It does.
Interesting.
Think about that before you mash the hell out of one next time.
Going back to the problem of having one a day, that requires some serious planning. Because you can't go to the unless you go to the store every day to get the fresh avocado, but you gotta plan like gradients of ripeness while you're buying your avocado.
I would think so, and I have no idea how to tell whether they're the right or not.
Tip, because whenever I buy an avocado, I'm usually consuming it within like 8 hours,
okay,
maximum. If you go early in the morning, I know they do this in Valley. I don't know if they do this everywhere. But the produce guys at Valley will kind of pre-sort the avocados and put the real riper ones down below, so people are grabbing those up first, and the less riper up top. So if you get there early enough, you can see the gradient sometimes, like in the on the shelf there, the lower ones are ready to go today. And
is there a visual indicator?
Like
Just looking at an avocado.
Yeah.
If I've got three avocados sitting on the table of different degrees of ripeness, you can look at it and tell me which one is closer.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. The darker they get.
Darker.
They really, really can't go horribly bad until they get, you know, far too gone. Up in that, it's just, I mean, I'm mushing it anyway. I don't care how soft it is in there.
That's right. Mortal and Pestle will take care of you.
Yeah.
847, News Talk 1440, WROK.